Well, everybody, welcome to Managerial Accounting Introduction Part 6. We're determining cost of goods manufactured and cost of goods sold. Okay. So what we've done before this is in the last video, we went through and we did the setup, right? We went through and we did the full blown setup. And now we're going to call this COGM. Okay. So I've set all these accounts up to determine cost of goods manufactured, right? And I've gone through, I've identified what's factory overhead, what's SG&A. So now I'm going to use this information and I'm going to go through and determine over here, what is our cost of goods manufactured? So now we're going to play a balancing game. It's called let's balance the T accounts. Does 770 plus 700 equal 85? And the answer is no. Right. So like right over here, what we have to go through and do is to say, well, 70 plus 700 minus X equals 85. Right. We like the calculus that's required in accounting. No. So all I'm doing right now is I'm balancing the T accounts. So over here, 70 plus 700 subtract over here gives me 85. If I isolate X, 70 plus 700 minus 85 equals X. Right? That's the same thing as 1x. What is this equal to? So this is going to be 70 plus 700 minus 85. This is going to be 685. Okay. So just let's check our work. 70 plus 700 minus 685 is equal to 85. What is this called that we had to use to balance this? Well, this is our demon master, or what we call our direct materials. Okay. So DM is Disney magic, but it is also direct materials. Okay. So right over here, our direct, I like the Disney magic, but I'm going to get sued for it over a copyright if I go more than a few more seconds. So right over here, we've got this at 685. Now, raw materials inventory can have a beginning balance, have an ending balance because it does actually exist. But factory payroll, this has to have a zero balance. So 500, right? Got my 500 over here. I had direct labor of 440. This direct labor, though, is not going to be able to sit here on its own, right? It's got to travel, and it's going to travel to work in process, right? So DL is direct labor. Okay. So right over here, this is going to be go into work in process inventory. So the direct labor travels over here to work in process inventory. So, but am I balanced? And the answer is no, I am not balanced. So over here, I need to balance my entry. 500, this has to go down to zero. So this is going to be 60. So if I was doing this also for direct labor, I'd have 500 minus 440 minus X equals zero. So this would be 60 minus X equals zero. X is going to be equal to 60. Let me just fix that. Okay. So, but where does this indirect labor travel to? Okay. This indirect labor over here is going to be traveling over here to factory overhead. Okay. So my indirect labor or my IL is going to come over here. Now, what does factory overhead have to balance down to? Well, it has to go to zero. So let's make this go to zero. So I have total factory overhead costs of 60 plus 47 plus 115 plus 48 plus 79 plus 38 plus 20 equals Bennett doesn't know how to use Excel. That's right. I'm not very good at it. Please, 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 you have to go through and learn Excel. Okay, very, very important skill heading into the workplace. Okay, so right over here, to make this account go to zero, right? Once I put in 407, this account is now at zero. So where is this going to go over here? This is my factory overhead. Okay, so this 407 is going to come right over here to factory overhead. Okay, so right over here, I've got 407. Okay, so FOH is factory overhead. All right. Now, to determine cost of goods manufactured, as we saw from the previous video, what are we going through and trying to figure out? My cost of goods manufactured is going to be what I'm going to need to do to balance this T account. So if I have over here my beginning WIP of 100 plus my Demon Master Disney Magic of 685 plus my direct labor of 440 plus my factory overhead of 407 minus Z equals 20, what is this going to equal to? Well, if I take 100 plus 685 plus 440 plus 407 minus 20, I'm going to get 1612. We need to make sure that that works. So 100 plus 685 plus 440 plus 407 minus 1612 equals 20. So I am good to go. This is our cost of goods manufactured. This is now going to come over here and travel to finished goods inventory. So this is our cost of goods manufactured. Now let's go through and finish this. We're almost at the finish line, right? So we've got cost of goods manufactured. Now, does 168 plus 1612 equal 44? The answer to that is if you said yes, then I would say, well, we got to do some other stuff first. So let's go over here and come up with a nice green color over here that we're in the month of St. Patrick's Day. So right over here. So what's my cost of goods sold? Well, if I take 168 plus 1612 minus AA equals 44, what is this going to be equal to? So 168 plus 1612 minus 44 is 1736. So that is going to be my cost of goods sold. Let's just add it up to make sure this works out. And it does. Always check your work. That's why we like to go through and to use T accounts, because it makes that part of it that much easier. So for this particular question, what we just went through and did, determine the cost of goods manufactured right over here is going to be 1612. Determine the cost of goods sold. Our cost of goods sold is going to be 1736. So I'm going to stop there. We're going to come back in a moment and we're going to do a multi-step income statement. Can't wait to do that one. And thank you again for joining me here today. If you have any questions or you would like to see additional videos, please appreciate it. And please just let me know if you have any other questions. I look forward to seeing you on the next video. Have a great day.